Howdy folks, and welcome back to Let's Play Might and Magic, the World of Xeen. As per usual, we are just going to go ahead and jump on in here. And where we last left off, we had copy protection! Yay! Anyways, we were on the Island of Fear, and... Oh, they can come through doors. Well, that's actually pretty good to know. Because, yeah. Well, this episode's starting off on a really positive note. Oh, Lord. Okay, well, that's good to know. Because now I know that I've got Minotaurs on my ass, which is not good. Alright, so we're going to come outside. We're going to sleep. Let's see here. And I can't remember who I had the Lloyd's Beacon on. Right. Yep. Okay. Well, here. What time is it? Yeah, we should have enough time, I think, to do that, and then town portal to Lakeside, and then just, well, not walk across, but meander our way across the water here. We have sorcery. Yeah. Okay, so I'm gonna save again right here. Episode 21. Can't believe we're already at episode 21. It seems like we're getting to the point, like, episode-wise now, that we were nearly at the end of the game on in the original run through this. But I'm kind of taking my time a little bit more this time. Okay. Keeping an eye out. Alright, there they are. So I'm gonna open this up with some pretty heavy magic here. I think I'm gonna nail them with a Starburst. Ah, that's not an AoE. Is Implosion an AoE? No! Alright. Well, in that case, See, I gotta start using the keyboard. It makes it a lot easier. I wonder if they're susceptible to sleep. No. Alright. See here. Mass Distortion? Well, that's kind of an AoE. Oh, there goes Rove. That doesn't surprise me. I really don't know how I want to really handle these guys, truth be told. I'm just gonna cast a power cure on Rove. See about getting him back up. And we're gonna go ahead and focus on this one that got hit by the mass distortion. Rove can go ahead and... See, Starburst is not an AoE. I actually thought Starburst was an AoE. Between it and Implosion, I thought one of them was, but apparently not. That actually kind of ruffles my butt a little bit. I suppose we can try hitting him with a fireball. I can't tell if that just maybe didn't affect one or what. Alright, so we're just going to melee this guy down. Okay. Now, the one thing about these guys is that they are actually worth a pretty substantial amount of XP. Holy crap, Rove. Where were you? Yeah, I was gonna say, I'm gonna bet at least some of the party members are eligible. Yeah, that is one thing about Darkseid, is the monsters start becoming worth just absurd amounts of experience points. Alright, we're gonna try this other group here. I'm just going to try meleeing them. That's why I saved before I did this. Well, I don't know. I suppose I can throw some magic here. I just can't believe that Starburst is not an AoE. I thought it was. It's maddening. Oh, come on, guys. Come on. There's only one left. Chunk, it's on you. Oh, Chunk's down, and Devon saves the day. Alright, so we're gonna pull back to here again. We're gonna sleep. I'm gonna save. I said I'm gonna save. And we are going to Lloyd's Beacon out. Now, as I've mentioned, these are the easy ones. Don't forget that. Because the harder ones are much harder. And I'm gonna be raging, I think, because it's ridiculous. Okay, Day of Sorcery. Back in we go. I'm not gonna bother leveling because we're,
what are you looking at? Go on in.
we're like at the point now where we've got a shrine that gives us 15 levels, and in the grand scheme of things, one extra level on top of 15, not great. So you want to go down? Well, yeah. Did you turn all the hourglasses? No. How could you be so negative? Be gone. Now, I don't know if you actually have to turn all of the hourglasses, but it says to turn all the hourglasses. So yeah, we'll flip the hourglasses. Now remember, this is very much the place of positive thinking. Okay, I don't think there's any in here, no. I'm of course going to check all of the rooms just to, you know, make sure the game devs aren't being sneaky. Okay. Yes. We did turn all the hourglasses. Are you sure? Yes. Okay, I believe you. Go ahead. Alright. I'm gonna be saving a lot. I'm just gonna warn you guys of that now. This place is horrible. Alright, soul waters. Now, if I recall correctly, these things do something horrible to you, so I'm gonna have Devon drink. Refreshing. Alright, maybe not. I thought they, like, aged you or something, but apparently not. Although we do have some aging going on. I think that's from the Minotaurs. I do believe they age you. The water is stagnant. The water is stagnant. The dial is set to 1. Turn? Sure. That's set to 2. Didn't do anything to the water, though. And the heads are like, no, don't turn it. Don't turn it. You'll kill us all. And I'm like, okay. We'll leave them at the default for now. Go ahead and let loose some arrows. Yeah, the one-on-one Minotaur fights, not bad. And this one's at 2. If I recall correctly, you need to set like all of them on one side to one thing and all of them on the other side to something else. I don't know. Man, even Rove's mixing this up. Yeah, this one's at 3. And this one's at 4. Carefully, carefully approach. And then we have a lever. Okay, what's this say? Turn all dials up, pull lever, and drink the sauce of the sauce. The souls of the adventurer's path. Alright, so we're gonna do that on this side. Okay, so this lever. That lever is up. So this one is up. Well, dial, rather. That one is up. This one is up. As you can see, pull the lever. Wrong lever! Why do we even have that lever? Alright. So, drink the souls of the lost. Alright. Look at that. 654,321 experience point. 654321. Alright. Same thing. Oh, that one killed her. I love it. It's just like completely unceremonious. She's just like, nope, Brunhilde's dead. Although, admittedly, it's like, bam, or Brunhilde, Devon is dead. No one cares. Go ahead and get some power cures flowing here. Heal everybody up a little bit. How are we all looking? Okay, that is acceptable. Alright, come on, Devon. Try us again. There we go. Chunk. Okay. And this is what I meant where I said the game developers, I'm not going to say they stopped caring about game balance, but they stopped caring about game balance. Well, really, it's not even that. It's just a case of, like, the numbers get bigger. Alright, now I have to, like, not forget. I gotta write this down that Devon was the last one that drank, because otherwise I'll forget. Devon. Okay. Now, I think we want to do that on this side. Of course, I'm going to kill all the Minotaurs now, beforehand. Just in case. You know, and we'll clear this out, and then I'll probably be sitting on like a level or two for every party member. And we'll be good. Oh, I was going to say, I thought there were more Minotaurs in here. Alan Rove's out. We'll just see how far we can kind of progress here. And one more. Come on, guys. There we go. Alright, so that's everybody. And now you'll know that there are no levers on this side. It's just fountains. Which, I don't know if these guys are safe to drink from. So here, let's test. Gold leaf, right? Refreshing. Alright. Gold leaf. Okay, so there we go. So we're still good to drink. So, Rove. Okay, and how many more do we have? One, we have two left, so I'm gonna give those to both casters. Because they need them more, because extra levels for them equates to more spell points. Alright, so what do we have here? Do you wanna go down? Yes. Did you drink from all of the fountains? No, actually we did not. We did not drink from these central fountains. Just having gold leaf sample all of them. Okay, and we did drink from that one. So now we actually have drank from all the fountains, including the one there that kills us. So yes. Yes. Yeah, mostly. Positive, yeah, sure. Okay, I believe you. Go on ahead. Alright, we're gonna save again. The statue speaks as you approach. All of the lost souls of this dungeon have become lost because they did not think positively. If you wish to stay found, think positive. Okay. Now, of course, this is a maze. And there are minotaurs. Many, many minotaurs. Many minotaurs. I'm probably in some serious trouble here. So I'm actually gonna have him time distort. And we're gonna run. Oh. Okay, go ahead and sleep. Let's see what time it is. 6 a.m. Alright, so spells have reset. So, Lloyd's Beacon. Actually, you know what? Here, Town Portal to Sand Caster. We'll do some leveling.
Okay, go ahead.
Because I do believe, yeah, I've got 13,000 gold. That's not going to be even remotely enough, but we can at least give the old college try. Yeah, as you can see, the gold price is getting much higher here. We are definitely going to need to hit a bank. Which... I honestly don't remember if there's a bank in... Oh god, we missed a mage, apparently. Get out of here. There's gotta be a bank in here. Glass and iron. The oasis. See, this is the guild. Or no, that's a temple. Let me check the map. Well, the map is, of course, pretty well useless, so we're just gonna town portal to Sandcastle, Castleview, because that's a town that I actually know the layout of.
Go ahead.
Here, I suppose I can flip my map on for you guys. Okay. See, not there, or there. Or is it? Dang bank. There it is. Milton Savins. Withdraw. Gold. We'll go with 200,000. Okay, back to Sandcaster.
Got a pass. Okay, go ahead.
Man, that dude's hair. I still can't get over it. Like, he's gotta be putting a bunch of crap in there. Alright, let's see how many we get here. So there you go. Pretty decent amount of levels. I'm okay with that. Okay, so I'm gonna save again because, you know, cowardice, the usual. It's 10 a.m. We will Lloyd's Beacon. We will do that. We will town portal to Lakeside. We will buff. Day of Protection. Yeah, as you can see, we did pick up a bunch of extra spell points. That I'm appreciative of. Okay.
What are you looking at? Go on in.
Go on in. Like, fucking smokes 12 packs a day. Okay. Now, there's gonna be a horde of minotaurs down here just waiting for us. And what we want to do is actually... We're gonna teleport, I think. Oh, and the spell failed. Crap. Alright, we're gonna wait right here. They're gonna come to us as I kick my table. Okay, as my chair squeaks, everybody's raging now. Okay, so spells aren't gonna really do too much on these guys, so I'm just gonna kind of focus on keeping people alive, I guess. We do melee them down, you know, fairly easily. So can I just hit them with, like, an energy blast? Some low B damage spells there. Okay, power cure on Devon. Power cure on Rove. Alright, so that wasn't too bad, all things considered. I mean, we chewed through some mana. But we're to the point in the game now where... Here, let me flip back onto the real auto map. We're at the point in the game now where, as you guys can see, kind of like just leaving an area that's dangerous and coming back is really a non-issue. So we're gonna arrow this guy. Oh, and this is a Gorgon. So this is trouble right here. These guys have got a boatload of hit points. I'm gonna want to implode this guy, and I'm also going to want to mass distortion him, because, like I said, these things have... Yeah, and they do that. Oh, and there's more than one. Great. Oh, there's three. Wow. Okay, I was not expecting three of them. I knew there were Gorgons on this level, but I figured they were going to kind of come at me maybe one at a time. Well, I guess I've learned that the game is not kind. Okay, so we know that, I think that was down this way. No, that was not. Well, it was over here. We know that over there is sadness. Sadness, wailing, and gnashing of teeth. What else we got? Alright, this is just a Minotaur. I can handle this guy. Kinda just take our time here. So we have a lever, and if I recall correctly, you have to pull all the levers. Actually, don't know if there's one over there or not on the other side of this wall. Just keeping people alive at this point. And honestly, like, I don't know outside of using that shrine that gives you, you know, the 15 temporary levels, I don't know how you would be expected to come through this place. Like, the amount of outside and there's the petrification. The amount of outside leveling you would have to do is, you know, pretty incredible. And I honestly don't even know where you'd do it. I don't know how I got through this place on my last game. I do remember there was a lot of whinging going on. So we're gonna go ahead and, you know, wuss out. Sleep here. And let's see, what time is it? 10 at night, we'll sleep again. 6 a.m. Okay, Lloyd's Beacon, return, activate. And town portal. And I'm sure some of you are probably wondering why I haven't just had Devon set a Lloyd's Beacon, like, in the dungeon where we are. Partially that's because I don't want to have to make that run out to the Fountain of Youth ever again. So it's mostly me being lazy. I don't know. I might, you know, reset it so that we do it in here. Because really, it's not a hard run to get there. It's just, you know, it's a straight shot east of Castleview through a bunch of woods. Okay. Round, like, five. And this dungeon does not get any easier from what I recall either. Because, like, from this point onward, like, I think there's one more level, maybe two. All you fight are Gorgons. And as we've seen, not good. Oh, and immune to magic, too. At least this one's getting lucky on his spell resistance rolls. Come on, guys. Just having everybody just spam death magic at this thing. Pull the lever. Okay. Go ahead and save. Come down this way. Oh, is that two Gorgons or is that two Minotaurs? Alright, two Minotaurs. These guys get the melee treatment. Because I'm really not really at all worried about them. I mean, I suppose I can heal through it a little bit here. Dang it. Rover. Gold Leaf, rather. Get your heal on. Mouse cursor, get off a chunk's face. Alright, that I'm willing to bet is a Gorgon. Oh, no, another Minotaur. Alright. I'm happy for that. Okay, we've got another thing there. I'm gonna save. Let's see, I wish there was a... There's probably a hotkey to bring this thing up, but I don't know what it is off the top of my head. Are you a Gorgon? Alright. So you wanna go down? Yes. Did you pull all four levers? Sure we did. Yeah. Yes. Oh no! So yeah, that's what happens if you don't do what they tell you to do. I think we're sitting at three of the four levers. Alright, she does not have the mana for another power cure. And of course, this thing immediately goes for poor Swell in the front row. So basically what we're going to be doing here is saving after every fight. Alright, so that is the fourth lever I want to say. Yes, 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 okay. It believes me because I actually did it, but it knows. Alright, so we're going to go ahead and just set this thing because why not? Okay, 6 in the afternoon, sleep. So it should be 2 in the morning. Okay, new. Lloyd's Beacon, return. Yes. Okay. Return. There. Expedited. This, I know I've mentioned it before. I think I mentioned it last time when we first started. I really honestly think this is probably, I would say, the second hardest dungeon in the entire game. Oh yeah, that's right. There's like a little, there's a slider puzzle here, which isn't, if I recall correctly, nearly as difficult as it could be. And it's fascinating. Like, here, watch the floor. See how the floor changes? So, like, the floor tiles aren't set, they just mirror every other step. Which is kind of a mind screw. Okay, flip that one, flip that one. Alright, so we flipped all the levers. So now I think we should be able to, oh no, we can't. Alright. Well, flip this one, flip this one, and flip this one. Come back here, and see, that's the bottom one, and that's the top one. Okay, now we should be able to, or maybe not, the game's screwing with me. Can we open this door? No. Can I? Let's see, where is it? Etherealize through the door. Yes, but it's something that I really didn't want to do. Alright, Gorgon is primary target here. So we are going to... No, Starburst. Okay, so Starburst is an AoE, it's just they've been getting really lucky on their saves. Good to know. Apparently Mass Distortion is as well. Ugh. Well, in that case, yeah, I was gonna say, I'm just gonna be spamming this stuff. Oh, another Gorgon. Who's eaten at least one Starburst, because I know they've been taking damage back there. But as you can see, the incredible amounts of health they have by comparison to pretty much everything else. Okay, I'm gonna heal Chunk because I'm fairly certain that Rove is, yeah, at a negative 124 hit point threshold, but more importantly, completely out of spell points, the useless cad. Alright, so I see some more Minotaurs back there. Okay, so we gotta drop 3 Minotaurs with, you know, injured party members. But these are injured Minotaurs, so we might be able to chop through these guys, and it looks like we can. So I'm gonna sleep, because holy god, I'm honestly quite surprised that we survived that. I'm also going to save, because cowardice. Return. Oh, whoops. Wrong one. That would be this one. use that. Okay, return. And day of protection, and day of sorcery. And once more, etherealize through the door. What's this say? Flank at the base of the statue reach, start from the north and go to the south, third from the top and far to the east, pull the lever you suspected least. Oh damn. Alright. As I adjust myself in my chair once more. Okay, I gotta write this down. See here. Start north. Go south. Third from top. And far east. Pull lever suspected least. Okay. Well, that's a hint enough if I ever heard one here. Ow. Ow, ow. Seriously, guys, you're gonna make me walk through. They are, in fact, making me walk through fire. I don't even know if this is hurting me. Yeah, it's doing a couple points of damage. Minotaur's private reserve. Devon? Oh. 7,654,321 experience points. Anybody else? Okay. Oh, but now it's only refreshing. Well, my three front rows probably just gained a lot of levels there. Holy crap. Sorry, back row guys. I guess we don't really love you. Gonna etherealize through this. Okay, so I'm gonna have to reflip all of these levers. Oh, the lever's stuck. Oh, they're all stuck here, huh? Alright, let's see. The lever is stuck. Oh, that's actually probably there. Now we should be able to pull them again. Or maybe not. None of them? Really? Well, I didn't magically solve the puzzle. Oh, this is worrisome. Alright, well, it says start at the north, three from the top. So this is 1, 2, 3. Unless. Oh! Far to the east. Pull the lever you suspected least. Ha! Alright. So you want to go down? Yes. How about giving up 1,000 gold? Sure. 5,000 more? Sure. 10,000 more? Sure. 250,000 more? Sure. Not enough gold. Oh! It's okay. We gotta go to town and bring back a lot of money. Castleview! Actually, how much do I have on me? 64,000? Screw that. Lakeside! Or not Lakeside. Dang it, I'll get there eventually. Sandcaster. See how many levels we pulled out of that.
Okay, go ahead.
I'm gonna bet we don't have enough money to level them, but we might as well check. Okay, these guys get priority. Alright. Yeah. Alright. Alright. This is gonna be a little bit crazy. I'm gonna probably pull like. Oh. I don't remember how much gold you need to get through this questionnaire and the dungeon. I think it's like a pretty substantial amount. So I'm gonna actually withdraw 1,000,000. Alright, town portal back to Sandcaster. We'll get our level on. And then we'll go down to the next level, and that's probably where I'm gonna call it. So, honestly, with this, like, bajillions of experience points we got, this is gonna allow our front row to kind of catch up with the back row. Actually, pretty much exactly catch up with the back row. Because these guys are in, like, the low 30s. Yeah, these guys are all level 34. Except for Chunk, who's, you know, weeping at level 29. But there we go. Party's sitting, you know, pretty beefy. We're definitely getting there. What time is it? 3 a.m. So we're gonna sleep. Okay, we're going to. Where's the Lloyd's Beacon at? There's the Lloyd's Beacon. Lloyd's Beacon. Use it. Okay. Light's beacon, use it, and day of protection. Wait, what? Not enough gems. Oh my god! Like, the one time in the game that I actually run out of gems. Do I just have, like, no gems? I have 4. Of course, I'm 1 short. Well, give me a light spell. Freaking troll game. At least they make it straightforward to get out of here. I wasn't even paying attention to that. I've never had to worry about my gems. And now we're out. Uh-oh. Well, this could actually prove kind of troublesome if I can't water walk. Okay, they had the foresight to give me water walk as a freebie. I'm thankful for that. Oh great, armadillers. In the one case in this game that they're gonna be a challenge to us when we don't have any of our buffs running. If I didn't know any better, I'd actually say that the overland monsters might have respawned. Which I don't think is supposed to happen. That arm going the wrong way. I can't be though, I'm going south. And south is where you gotta go. Hey there, snake. Get out of here, killer cobra. Nobody likes you. Or you stupid mantises. Here, I suppose I could cast Wizard Eye, huh? Use some of those few remaining gems I've got left. Get out of here. Okay, so that's Chunk going unconscious. Seriously, Mantis Ant, get out of here. Okay, now we're gonna wanna stay in the forest, because otherwise we're going to risk bumping into troll holes. And we don't have enough wherewithal to not fall down them now, because we're not flying, or levitating, rather. Okay, so here's Castle View. That was unnecessarily harrowing.
Okay, go ahead.
So let's try this again. Where is the bank? Oi, withdraw gems. We've got 38,000, so I'm gonna pull 2,500 of them. Sleep. Jeez. Alright, now we can just Lloyd's Beacon back in. Day of Protection. Day of Sorcery. Okay. I'm gonna save before I do this, actually. Yes. 1,000, 5,000, 10,000, 250,000. Okay, that'll about cover the minotaurs you destroyed and the mess you made. Go ahead, enjoy yourself. Okay, so we're gonna save and call it. So, as per usual, folks, thank you for watching, and I will catch you all next time wherein I think we're probably going to finish up the Dungeon of Lost Souls. Until then.